Now, if we take a look at the Raspberry Pi Pico development kit that we will cover from this session, you can visit this homepage and purchase it through this link. You may have used Raspberry Pi a lot, but just in case there are those who are not familiar with the Pico, I would like to explain that the Pico is somewhat different from the Raspberry Pi that we generally know. The operating system that runs on it is separate. It is designed to be affordable and easy to handle in embedded systems similar to Arduino. Despite being inexpensive, its performance is quite high. For instance, it features a Cortex M0 processor and, like the NRF52840 we have used so far, it also includes a variety of functions such as SPI and UART. So it is set up like this, and if you look now, you have connected the NRF52840 module to the expansion kit as you did in the last session. If you already have an existing expansion kit currently in your possession, there is absolutely no need or requirement to buy the Pico kit separately. Instead, you can simply and conveniently purchase the Pico module on its own. You can simply purchase the Pico module and use the existing expansion board, as you see here. Of course, if you look inside the Pico kit, you will find that there is no OLED display in the NRF52840 kit. If you look at the configuration here, the LEDs are basically and essentially the same. But if you choose the most common bundle configuration, it includes additional items. The 1.77-inch LCD can also be controlled. And if we look at the components we've seen before, they are almost identical. So, for those who have already followed along with the NRF52840 kit, you actually don't need to buy the entire kit again. You can just purchase the Pico module. Let me explain this as we go through the content. I have laid out the contents of the Pico kit here. As you can see, there is an expansion board inside. As I explained earlier, those who have already purchased the NRF52840 kit do not need to buy the same kit again. You can simply purchase the Pico and the adapter module included here and use them in the same way. In the case of the Pico kit, if you choose the most common option, such as the choice that is most frequently selected, it comes equipped with a 1.77-inch LCD display screen, which is a feature that was previously unavailable with the NRF52840 kit in the earlier version. Other than this, all the other parts and components are essentially identical in nature. Upon arrival, it comes in an unsoldered state, so you will notice that there are metal pin headers neatly and systematically arranged in two rows in a parallel fashion. You need to carefully solder these components and subsequently insert these into the designated expansion circuit board for operational control. Now, let us proceed and begin the process to solder the components. First of all, carefully place the two pin headers underneath the board, then gently position these components and ensure they are securely fastened in place. In this current state, I will now proceed to solder the top row of pins. When you are soldering, it is advisable to begin with the outer corners initially. I have now successfully soldered each of the corners, and at this point, I will now proceed to solder the inner sections as well. You can easily solder it in this manner. Next, you see the adapter PCB we looked at earlier, right? Here, you should insert the soldered Pico on top like this. And then, just like we did before with the NRF52840 module, you can insert it the same way. By doing this, everything is now ready. In this session, we looked at the contents of the Raspberry Pi Pico kit, and I demonstrated how to solder the Pico module to connect it to the expansion board. Starting from the next session, I will explain how to connect this Pico module and proceed with CircuitPython. Then, I will see you next time.